Now, it is my candid assessment that the present government's policy of reconciliation is not successful. In fact, this policy is creating bigger problems, problems that did not exist earlier. And far from improving the relations among the ethnic communities, the current approach to reconciliation is exacerbating differences, aggravating tensions. You know, reconciliation, of course, you have to address minority grievances and minority aspirations. But in no country can reconciliation succeed against the will of the majority. You have to carry the majority with you. If the majority feel insecure, suspicious, and do not identify themselves with the initiatives that are taken in the name of reconciliation, then you cannot expect to achieve success. Today, we have very clearly a situation in this country where the majority community feels alienated from the reconciliation process. Not only the majority, even the minorities. How can there be democracy even at the basic level in a country where elections are not held? Now, provincial council elections, as I speak to you today, in three provinces of this island, there have been no provincial councils. There have been no elected representatives of provincial councils for 10 months. The North Central Province, the Sabarmati Province, and the Eastern Province. By October this year, in 6 of the 9 provinces of Sri Lanka, there are no provincial councils. So, far from the Tamil community getting more devolution, the Tamil community gets zero devolution. No devolution at all. It's all controlled from the center. So, the Tamil National Alliance has a lot to explain to the Tamil people. What have they promised? What have they delivered? Our government under Mahinda Rajapaksa held provincial council elections in the north, knowing very well that we could not win. But a lot that is being done in the name of reconciliation is clearly the product of external pressure. Then you have a constitutional reform process which is opaque. It is lacking in any kind of transparency. Is there equality of treatment of the north and the south? Not at all. Police are not allowed to take any action in the north. So there is an obvious contrast. Then reconciliation must take into account sensitivities of people. Are we doing that? When it is said that Buddhist temples cannot be built in the north, and there's a massive outcry against the building of Buddhist temples, does that help the reconciliation process? So we strongly believe that the way to begin is by improving livelihoods for the northern people. This change, is it a change for the better or a change for the worse?